morning, everyone. In the last class, we have discussed that BMN coefficients are B coefficients and its expression in terms of voltage and power factors. And also we have derived the condition for optimal operation or economic operation of thermal power plants, including line losses. So in this video we will discuss about algorithm and flowchart of economic operation with line losses. First we will see the coordination equation and then algorithm and flowchart. So this is the OPF, optimal power flow or optimal operation of optimal operation or economic operation of thermal power plants, including line losses. The coordination equation, what we derived in the previous video, is ICI into Li equal to lambda. So this is the coordination equation. So ICI into Li equal to lambda, I is equal to 1 to n. So IC1 is equal IC1, IC2, so on, ICN. L1, L2 up to LN. Therefore, IC1 into L1 equal to IC2 into L2, that is equal to IC3 into L3, so on, IC3N into, ICN into LN equal to lambda. So IC is the incremental cost already derived in the previous videos. L1, L2 are the penalty factors of each of the power plants, 1, 2, 3 up to n number of generating stations. So n number of penalty factors are there. Now let us discuss about algorithm, OPF with line losses algorithm. Very first one is choose initial value of lambda, that is incremental cost, and delta lambda values. Delta lambda is used to increment or decrement the IC whenever it is necessary. This is the first step. Second step is PGI equal to 0 for I is equal to 1 to k. So for each generating plant, generating power is equal to 0 initial value. So therefore epsilon is used to have the tolerance. Epsilon is nothing but the tolerance value. Third step, so we have to read the generation limits, PGI minimum and PGI maximum. From the capability curve we understood that each generating station will have limitations, or each generating unit will have limitations, PG minimum and PG maximum. For I is equal to 1 to k for all plants, you can have generation limits. After having the limitations, next step is we have to solve the PGI expression, which is in terms of B coefficients. 1 minus Bi is the constant, Bi by lambda, minus 2 into sigma j is equal to 1 to k, j is not equal to I, Bij into Pgj whole divided by Ai divided by lambda. A is the constant, cost function constant, plus 2 Bii. So this is the expression. So please remember this expression for solving the PGI values, generating powers. Once you solve the PGI values, next one, fifth step is calculate the power loss, sigma I is equal to 1 to k, sigma j is equal to 1 to k, PGI Bij Pgj. So this is the product of generation and B coefficients. Once you calculate the PL value, now you got the Pg value, PL value. Demand is, let us have the constant value. Use that demand. Check the power balance equation now. Sigma Pg minus Pd minus PL less than epsilon. This is the power balance equation. Power balance equation. Once you verify the power balance equation, if it is yes, then you get the optimal solution, print the result. Otherwise, go to the next step. That is the last step, seventh step. Increase lambda by delta lambda if power balance equation is less than zero. Less than zero in the sense it is negative. Negative means you need to increase the power generation in order to get the power balance. Negative means PL, PD. So the PD is greater than PGI and hence you need to increase the generation. Therefore you need to increase the lambda by delta lambda, lambda plus plus. Or decrease lambda by delta lambda if power balance equation is greater than zero. That means sigma PGI is greater than PD plus PL. And hence you need to decrease the generation and hence lambda should be decreased by delta lambda, so that is lambda minus minus. And repeat the process from step 3 till we get the optimal solution. Once again, get review of algorithm. In the algorithm, first step you need to choose the IC naught, lambda naught and delta lambda values. Very important. So delta lambda value is useful in the iterative solution to increase or decrease the lambda to get the appropriate solution. Second one, assume PGI's initial generations are equal to 0 from I is equal to 1 to k and epsilon values. This is the tolerance value. And read the generation limits, PGI minimum, PGI maximum for all the units or all the generating plants. Now solve the equation for PGI in terms of Bij. And then next, you solve the PL, which is expressed in terms of Bij. Once you got both the values PL and PG, check the power balance equation. If it is less than epsilon, so tolerance, less than the tolerance or acceptable limit, then the solution is reached, print the solution. Otherwise, go to the next step. Increase the lambda by delta lambda if power balance equation is less than zero, negative. And decrease lambda by delta lambda if power balance equation is greater than zero, that is positive. And repeat the process from step 3 to get the optimal solution. Same thing, we will see the flowchart, OPF with line losses flowchart. Start, choose the initial value of IC naught, lambda naught and delta lambda and epsilon values. Assume PGI equal to 0 for all generating plants, I is equal to 1 to k, like in first step. And then, so this D is the iterative solution. So to repeat the process, D is coming from last part. We'll see that. So now, next step, calculate PGI. PGI equal to 1 minus Bi by lambda minus sigma 2 Bij Pgj, j is equal to 1 to k, j is not equal to I, divided by A by lambda, A is the constant, plus 2 Bii. This is the power equation in terms of Bij. And get calculations for each of the generating plant or generating station. And then for generating station, summation of all minimum powers is the minimum limit, summation of all maximum powers is the maximum power limit of the station. For individual unit, it is PGI minimum and maximum can be obtained from the capability curves. So if it is Pji is less than Pji minimum, if it is S, choose Pji equal to Pji minimum. So you already understand that you need to generate the minimum amount of active power, which is economical. Then it goes to B, this goes to A. Very first one, start, choose the initial values and lambda, epsilon values, and then calculate Pji, check the Pji limits, Pji minimum limit first, and then Pji maximum is, Pji is greater than Pji max, S, Pji is equal to Pji max. So beyond which you cannot generate, and hence it is Pji max. This is B, it is going to B. And then if it is no, increment the bus count, I plus plus. Initially you can choose I is equal to 0, I is equal to 1 in the first iteration. Here you can use I equal to 1. And here it is, increment the bus count, next bus it will go. And from point B it will come to bus count. And then next one, calculate the PL using expression, PL is equal to sigma, I is equal to 1 to k, sigma, j is equal to 1 to k, Pji, Bij, Pgj. And then you check the power balance equation, if it is less than epsilon, optimal solution is reached, otherwise go to C. From the C, is power balance equation less than 0, increment the lambda by delta lambda, otherwise if it is greater than 0, decrement the lambda by delta lambda. Then it goes to D. So you know D very well. Here it is the D. Like that it will go to iterative solution till it reaches the optimal solution. So till it reaches the optimal solution. This is the final step. Otherwise it will repeat the solution till you get the final solution. In a nutshell, OPF with line losses flowchart, start, choose the initial values and then calculate Pji, check the generation limits, and if it is violating generating limit, set it to lower limit if it is less than Pji minimum, set it to higher limit when it is greater than Pji maximum, and then increment bus count. Here you can choose the bus count, I is equal to 1. And here it is incremented till it completes all the generating 1 to k, 1, 2, 3 up to k, k number of generators are there, or generating stations are there. And next one, calculate the PL line loss by using Bij expression, and then check the power balance equation, if it is less than epsilon allowable limit, then it is optimal solution. Otherwise go to next checking point, that is if it is power balance equation less than 0, increment the lambda by delta lambda. If it is greater than 0, decrement the lambda by delta lambda, lambda is equal to lambda minus delta lambda, and go to D. D is again calculate the Pji. This is the process, iterative process to complete the solution. Till you will get the solution, it will be repeated. This is the flowchart of optimal solution with line losses, or economic operation of thermal power plants with line losses. I will stop here. Thank you. In the next video, we will discuss about various calculations related to optimal operations.